Every day we're giving you a spiritual practice that will help you stay strong with the Lord. Ken Shigematsu, a pastor from Vancouver, you're walking us through these practices. Let's talk about less is more. That's a practice to help us keep spiritually fresh. What is less is more?
Right. I was getting ready to fly to Manila on an overnight flight from Vancouver, and I'm at the counter, and I'm unexpectedly upgraded.
Oh, so, I like that.
Yeah, yes. It's a nice surprise. And so I'm pretty excited as I go into business class. The flight attendant, Maria, gives me a menu. I open it up. I feel like I'm in a fancy restaurant. There is papaya salad, beef tenderloin. So I order the entree. But then I remember, I've already had dinner. I'm not especially hungry. So I invite Maria over. I say, can you cancel that? When a person feels full, they don't crave food in the same way. And when we feel full of God's Spirit, content in our relationship with God, we're less likely to pine after material possessions, the latest gadget. So we can live simpler and we can give more. You know, all the proceeds from Survival Guide for the Soul are going to World Vision and to missions that work with vulnerable children.
That's wonderful, because you're on the board at World Vision.
I'm on the board.
And that's part of your less is more, is
part of
saying
more.
We don't need another book, prophets, but we want to do this teaching.
Yeah.
Okay, so less is more. What am I triggering into about God's heart there, about trying to live on less?
Well, it's interesting that Jesus was the one person who could have determined his net worth before he was born. He was God and then becomes a human being in Jesus. He doesn't decide to have the net worth of Jeff Bezos of Amazon or the founder of IKEA. Instead, he chooses to be born into a poor family. I think he does that because he wants to stand in solidarity with the poor, but also he wants to grow in dependence on his Father in heaven and have less to clutter his relationship with God.
Now, you actually think we should practice maybe giving away 10 things. Like today, I should go through my closet and go, this is not needed. What happens when I divest myself of things that I thought I needed?
I'll go through my closet and garage. If I haven't used something for a year, it's going to the Salvation Army. Marie Kondo, the other Japanese writer, says, if it doesn't bring you joy, give it away. And when you do that, you feel lighter, and there's literally less that clutters your heart, your life, and your connection with God.
All right. Simple abundance. The idea that less is more.
Right.
A spiritual practice that gives us more time to focus on God, gives us more time to think about being dependent on the giver of all good gifts.
Right.
All right, Pastor Ken Shigematsu has put these together in Survival Guide for the Soul, different spiritual practices that help us stay fresh with God. Here's how you can get your copy.